How it started? It was started by General Pervez Musharraf, who was the army chief of Pakistan. He, without the knowledge of then Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, led his men into the LOC, that is like of control, and they entered India. It was not the Indian army who reported that the intruders had entered India, but it was a local shepherd who told us that the Pakistanis had entered our border. Kargil was named after the success of Operation Vijay. It was called Operation Vijay by our army men. On this day, 26 July 1999, India successfully took command of the high outpost which had been lost to Pakistani intruders. This, the picture out here, is a memorial theme for the army men who lost their life in Kargil War. There are some basic facts about the Kargil War. The date it started in 1962. It started from May to July 1999. Location was Kargil district, Jammu and Kashmir. The result was Indian victory. India gained possession of Kargil. Combatants were, of course, India and Pakistan. Other less popularly used names included Third Kashmir War, and Pakistan's full name given to the infiltration was Operation Buzzard. The army chief that time, the Indian army chief was Veer Prakash Malik, and the Pakistani army chief, as I stated earlier, was General Pervez Musharraf. This is a map. This was the line of control, and your contour. This is India and this is Pakistan. Therefore, from here, and this whole region was taken up by them. And our men very bravely fought and regained the areas. These are some basic facts again about the Kargil War. It is not a conventional war. During that time, the Prime Minister of India was Dr. Bihari Vajpayee. And he and his government were very fond to use the word war. It would then, create a very conflict situation. So they used the word conflict. It was known as Kargil conflict. It was only after the war was won, it was named Kargil War. At a great height, it was above, the battleground was about 5,000 meters above the sea level, which was freezing cold, and it was very, very, very difficult situation for the men to fight. It was post-war, after being nuclear capability, the second nuclear test missile of India weather in 1998, following Pakistan's fall. So, in 1999, it was the first, one of the first war which took place after between two nuclear missions. Media coverage. Electronic media was on the rise, and this was one of the very publicized wars, and the general public was able to know that happening, or what was happening up there in the world. It was very publicized, and it created a sense of patriotism amongst Indians. Failure on both sides. If we say that Pakistani failed on political level, but India did fail on intellectual level because they were not able to, the army did not report that the intruders had entered India, it was a local shepherd. After that, they had taken many steps to look into the matter. This memorial has a slightly too deep meaning of certain army members who lost their lives but were very important. They were Grenadier Yogendra Singh Yadav, Lieutenant Manoj Kumar Pandey, 4-5 Rifles, Captain Vikram Batra, 13 JTA Rifles, Captain Anuj Nair, 17 Draft Regiment, Rajkumar Sanjay Kumar, 13 JTA Rifles, Manoj Rajesh Singh Adhikari, 18 Grenadiers, Captain Anirudh Singh, 11 Rajputana Rifles, Meera Hariya Malayavan, Sarah Burton, 1 Tihar, and Squadron Leader Ajay Mahuja, England Air Force, Havildar Chunilal, 8 JPA, LI. So I would just like to conclude by saying that more than 11 of our solutions given. The Pakistanis are trying to take possession of the Kashmir, but they feel very resolute, and this came to be as a lesson for all of them. I would like to say, in the words of our Supermania, you have never lived until you have lost your time, and for those who choose to fight life as a special favor, the project will never work. Thank you.